Hi everyone, welcome to TechCater. Today, I'm gonna make a video that's gonna help you to save data from your WordPress to Firebase, Realtime database, or Firestore. So I dedicate this video to David, one of the plugin supporters, and I hope that his music festival in this August 2020 will be launched. And now we're going to go to the main part. You might not know, but this is the main documentation that you should look at when referring to the plugin. And today we're going to go to the how to save data from WordPress to Firebase, either Realtime or Firestore. Okay. And with the help of contact form 7, this is another free WordPress plugin, so it makes it convenient for us to import data, create a new record to Firebase. Let me show you the demo. Okay, so this is the demo site, and the current version of the plugin is 0.11. Let me see. Okay, save data to Realtime database. This is the sample form that's going to help you to create a sample contact form and then display it on the WordPress front end. And then this is where people going to enter the information, either your customer or yourself. You can do it. Okay. And after you hit submit, the data are going to be inside your Firebase database. I suggest that you can copy the sample and then try to do it on your site to see if it works or not. And in the first three lines, you should notice this is important things. So this is where you define the collection names and the type of the database and any kind of options. For example, this form gonna save to user's collection. The database type is Realtime. If you want to save it to Firestore database, you can replace it by Firestore here. Actually, you can take a look at the example here. Okay. The only different thing is the name of the database type. That's all. Everything else is the same. Okay, now we go back. For troubleshooting the configuration, you can open inspect and open the network together with the console log. If there is any error, it's gonna display it under the console log. This is where you troubleshooting the plugin. I'm going to open the real-time database to see if the data is saved or not. Okay, this is my real-time database. I'm going to type something. Okay. I'm going to put a random date. Happy, maybe. You can see that the array type, it applies for hobby and food. That means when it saves data to the Firebase, it's gonna save as an array. Okay, and then I'm gonna submit. Okay, as you can see, there is no error yet, and the response inside the network or the console log here. Okay, so form is valid, and it starts saving to Firebase and the real-time database created with the ID here. If you choose the database type is Firestore, you're gonna say that the Firestore data is created with the ID. Something. Okay, and I'm gonna check it. Okay, here. So we have the database under the user collection here. So A35 and the email test something name. The foot is an array and then hub is an array too. So we successfully saved the data from WordPress to the real-time database in Firebase. So before you configure your site, you should read the documentation if there is any changes. And the first thing that I want you to know that before you save data to Firebase, you need to configure the Firebase environment. So this is the command that you should run, because if you don't define the collection in the environment, the function not gonna save for security purpose. So make sure that you only do this for the public database and configure your security rules inside the database to make sure that it's secured. So in order to set the environment, I guess that you already knew how to create an environment and deploy the function to Firebase. And go back to creating a public collection. It's the same thing. So this is my terminal. Okay, and then replay this one by my project ID. Remember to replace the sample collection name by your own. For example, you want to save data to event collection. You're going to replace user by events. And make sure that this is a public collection, so people can save to this public collection. Make sure that this is the right thing that you want to do. If you want to have more secure in terms of saving data, like who can save data to Firebase, you can send me an email. We can talk, or we can make a video call to discuss about it. But this gonna allow public, like everyone, can save data to your collection by filling the form that you created. So after you create your public environment, you can check the configuration if you have the correct one by having this command. So get public and then the project ID. So in the public collection, I have user as the collection. If you want to have like more than one public collection, you can recreate the configuration by adding more collection name into your public collection. Yeah, something like this is gonna make your collection public through your website. And if it doesn't work, remember to check your console log and any error under the network. If you have like any error and then you couldn't figure it out, you can take a snapshot of the log and then send the email to me. I'm happy to help. Now you know how to create a form to let people save data to your collection. In the next video, I'm going to add more tutorial for the Integrate Firebase to WordPress series. So thank you for listening. See you in the next video.